Girl Miko, and as promised, this is the tutorial for how I made this wig. Now, making wigs is a lot easier. It's not as hard as it seems. If you made glue projects and craft projects as a kid, you can make a wig, I promise you, because all we're doing is gluing tracks of hair to a wig cap. That's all it is, right? It's the same skills you learned as a kid. So I'm gonna walk you through all the steps that I take when I make my wigs, and this is a very beginner-friendly tutorial. It's very detailed and it's step-by-step. And even though I've made tons of wigs before, I still make mistakes too, right? I made a mistake when I made this wig and I started not to upload this video, but I thought, you know, this is a learning opportunity. This is an opportunity for you to learn from my mistakes and not have to make the same errors through trial and error, right? So don't worry, I got you. Before we get into the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button and join the Fit and Fabulous crew. And also, if you find this tutorial helpful, please like, comment, and share this video with your curl friends, okay? All right, crew, so let's get right into the tutorial. Now, of course, you're gonna need some hair, and I'm using hair that I got from Eunice Hair, and I got the Peruvian Jerry Curl in 3 bundles of 18, 20, and 22 inches with a 16-inch closure. Now, for supplies, I'm using my canvas mannequin head that I got from Amazon and my wig tripod that's made exclusively for making wigs. Now for my wig cap, I always use a spandex dome style wig cap. They are stretchy, they fit my hair perfectly. And because we're using the hot glue gun method, this is my hot glue gun that I got from Amazon, and I'm using the black glue sticks. I like using the black glue sticks because they dry black, they blend better with your hair. The clear glue sticks tend to dry with the white cast and they don't blend as well as the black. And I got the black glue sticks from Amazon as well. And you just insert the glue stick into the hot glue gun, plug it into an outlet, and wait for it to warm up, and you're ready to make your wig. And finally, you're gonna need scissors to cut your tracks. I recommend fabric shears because they make clean cuts and they don't fray the ends of your wefts. And I always cut my wefts for a less bulky look. All right, crew, we are ready to make our wig. Now, I like to cut a little bit of space around my ear on my wig cap because I like to wear side parts. And this little cutout prevents the hair and the wig from pushing my ear forward when I tuck my hair behind my ear. Plus, your wig just wears more comfortable when you do this. And the blue thing is my shower cap. I like to put a shower cap underneath the wig cap because the hot glue will seep through to your mannequin head, and the shower cap prevents your wig from sticking to the mannequin head. Now you can see I've already sewn down my closure, but you want to place it dead center and make sure it is super flat. And I wanted to show you where I place the hair at the hairline. So you can see the edge of the baby hair I place right at the end of the wig cap. Where you place your closure really depends on the shape of your hairline, but this is what works for me. Even though we're using the hot glue gun method, you want to make sure you sew down your closure because over time, as all that tugging from putting on your wig and taking it off, that tugging is going to loosen up the glue. So you want to sew down your closure so it's nice and secure. All right, now we're going to start laying tracks and get this wig finished. So you just start by applying the glue to the track and apply it to the wig cap. I'm starting at the very bottom of the wig cap and going from ear to ear. Now this glue dries really fast, so I apply a little bit of glue, press it to the wig cap, apply more glue, and just keep that process going. Now I am cutting my tracks. You don't have to worry about all the shedding hair from cutting your tracks because the hot glue seals your wefts to prevent all that extra shedding. And you can see sometimes I apply the glue to the track and sometimes I put it on the wig cap. It just really depends on where I am and where I'm trying to lay the track. And I just keep that process going from ear to ear. I'm gonna pull a little bit of this longest bundle to the front right over my ear because I want a layered look and I want to have some of that 22 inch in the front. Now I'm going to stop here and show you where we are with one bundle installed, because when I first started making wigs, the hardest part for me was determining how far apart to space my tracks. Now think of your wig caps in thirds, and each of your bundles should take up a third of the wig cap. And if you're still concerned about running out of hair, one trick that I do sometimes is I'll take some hair from my shortest bundle and install that right underneath my closure. And then I just use that as a guide of how far apart I need to be spacing out my tracks. If you do this, don't place the track right underneath your closure like I'm doing here.
I found that if you place it just a little bit beneath the closure, you have a more sleek look when you wear a side part. I actually ended up removing this track in the finished wig, and this is a before and after. You can see it looks a lot more natural. And I'm just going to keep laying tracks in a half moon fashion until I get the second bundle installed. Now, when you get to the edge of your wig cap and you snip the end of your track, make sure you tack it down with a little bit of glue so it's laying nice and flat and it's not sticking up in your finished look.
So this is how much space we have left over before we start installing the last bundle.
Now, while you watch me install this last bundle, let's talk about glue. So I prefer to use the glue sticks versus the bonding glue because if you want to reuse your hair, the glue sticks dry hard and you can peel them off and totally reuse your bundles. The bonding glue, on the other hand, dries really tacky and sticky and it's almost impossible to remove.
This is the important part, finishing it off. So I can lay one more track right here, right at the edge of the wig cap. We're gonna lay that right there.
All right, crew, so here's where I'm gonna show you one of the mistakes I made in making this wig. Now you can see my wig cap is gapping right underneath the closure. I ended up having to remake this entire wig because my closure would not lay flat. So learn from my mistake. Make sure your wig cap is pulled taut before you start laying your tracks. So we have the wig all finished, and so now we just need to cut off the wig cap underneath the closure. Make sure you don't cut too close to your stitching because you don't want any issues with your closure coming off, because if you mess that part up, you have to make your whole wig over. And this is what it should look like when you're done. And this is the wig all finished. And because my closure and all three of my bundles were varying lengths, this look already has a layered look to it. So I didn't have to cut in any layers. I didn't have to do any shaping or cutting of this hair at all. And that makes it really easy if you have a difficult time with cutting and shaping hair. And the closure already came pre-plucked, but I'm gonna pluck it just a little bit more just to thin out the hairline a little bit. And when you pluck, you wanna pluck behind the hairline. So you wanna section off a little bit of hair in the front and then start plucking behind, and just make sure you keep moving. Don't pluck in one place. That way you avoid having bald spots. And this is what the wig is looking like after I remade it. I made sure my wig cap was nice and flat before installing my closure and also before installing my bundles. I also placed a little bit of space between that last track and the closure. And you can see the closure is laying nice and flat. It's not puckering, it's not bulky, and it looks a lot more natural. And I must admit, I love this wig. These curls are so pretty and so soft and luscious. I can't wait to try some of the other styles that Eunice Hairs offers. So guys, I'm gonna leave the link to my review of this hair in the description box below, and I'm gonna link all of the products that I use in making of this wig. So guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. Make sure you join the crew by hitting that subscribe button, and also make sure you like, comment, and share this video if you found this tutorial helpful. Make sure you follow me on social media so you can hang out with me when I'm not on YouTube, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, stay beautiful, stay blessed, and make sure you stay fit and fabulous.